Basically, what we do is we correct the muscle function of the facial muscles, and we teach the tongue where to posture itself during rest and how to function normally and develop a lip seal, and very, very importantly, get them nasal breathing. The most severe myofunctional habit is poor tongue resting posture, followed by lips open. Then we would have mouth breathing, and we would also have a lot of non-nutritive habits such as thumb sucking, finger sucking, clothes, hair, anything at all that's been put into the mouth, nail biting, pen biting, etc. A whole bunch of things, but the biggest problem is when your upper jaw doesn't grow correctly to meet the lower jaw, you end up getting a mismatch. There are many different types of mismatches, but one of the biggest symptoms of a mismatch would be crooked teeth. But we get people that are very narrow. They've high vaulted palates. They have open bites because the tongue is pushing forward. And a lot of them have sleep issues because there just isn't enough room for the tongue, and the tongue has to fit somewhere. It has to go somewhere. And very often, particularly during the day, during the waking hours, the person will compensate very well for that small mouth and the mismatch or the malocclusion, as we call it. And the individual will develop compensations like tongue thrusting or poor tongue posture or an open mouth, which obviously gives you more room. And from that, you can subsequently maybe develop a mouth breathing habit. And particularly at nighttime, if the mouth is too small for the tongue again has to go somewhere. And very often when those muscles relax, it starts falling backwards and it begins to impinge on the airway. And that compromises the airway patency, particularly when all these, when the muscles of the upper airway, this collapsible part of the airway, particularly when those muscles begin to relax as well. And that can create sleep issues on a continuum ranging from snoring right across to obstructive sleep apnea. One is probably mouth breathing, because when the mouth is open, and so many parents think, oh, come in and see little Johnny, he's in there snoring, isn't he so cute? That's a big red flag. You don't want your cute little baby, little Johnny, snoring. And there, I think on our own website, we have a little shot of a dentist in Australia who has shown a photograph that if the baby's mouth is open while they're asleep, you can very gently just close it and they will keep it closed. But you have to keep doing that so that they learn how to keep their mouths closed while they're asleep. It's really, really important. We generally work initially with the lips and the tongue. We have lip exercises to strengthen the lips, which will encourage a lip seal. And we all know if the lips are closed, you can't breathe through your mouth. We also have many exercises to develop initially the tip of the tongue up behind the front teeth. And as the weeks and weeks go on, we get more and more of that tongue being able to rest in the roof of the mouth. And when we've achieved that, we work on swallowing exercises so that the tongue is the organ from start to finish when, you know, for the swallowing, okay, to initiate the swallowing, and the lips aren't being used or the neck muscles aren't being used to help with the swallow, because there are a lot of compensations that people make if the tongue isn't working properly during a normal swallow. So we have many exercises. unfortunately, I say here all the time, I wish I had a magic wand, because the only way you can repattern muscle function is by repetition. So these exercises have to be repeated and repeated and repeated. Well, you're working at a time when the face is growing at its fastest. If the face has grown at age six by about 70%, you have 70% of the problem. If you allow the face to continue to grow, and those problems, if you don't correct those problems, by age 12, which is the age that everybody is advised, well, you don't get orthodontics, you don't address crooked teeth until age 12, you now have 100% of a problem. And it's much harder to fix 100% of a problem than it is to fix 70% of a problem or 60% of a problem. So we would encourage everybody to address crooked teeth at a very early age, because we are not meant to have crooked teeth. We are not born. Crooked teeth is a symptom of something going radically wrong with the facial growth. Very often it is, yeah, because when somebody approaches us, they normally come in here with symptoms of poor myofunctional patterns, and the most common one being crooked teeth or a mismatch between the upper and lower jaws, in other words what we call a bad bite or a malocclusion. And we generally end up here having to, number one, address the muscle function and get that corrected, because if we're going to try and encourage a little bit of facial growth and make room for all of the teeth, then that won't be a stable end result unless we correct the muscles that created the problem in the first place. So in order to achieve the optimum outcome for the patient, we like to put the two together. And it's very important that the two are put together. There isn't a whole lot of point in straightening teeth if you're not going to address the thing that made them crooked in the first place, which is the muscle function. Buteyko breathing, which is really reducing the amount of breathing combined with nasal breathing, is really, really important. We encourage Buteyko breathing. I don't do it myself, but we recommend that they do the Buteyko breathing with two recommended Buteyko practitioners, Brian Murphy in West Cork and Patrick McKeown, who is in Galway, and he travels to Dublin and Cork, but we recommend it. Nasal breathing in and out through your nose is imperative. It is absolutely key to having your health and well-being. And your mouth is not for breathing. And it's not for breathing in exactly the same way as your nose isn't for eating. You'll never see anybody sitting down having their dinner through their nose. You know? But we will see huge numbers of people breathing through their mouth. We can see problems the moment the child is born. We can even see tongue tie in utero at 20 weeks. But it's very hard to get children under six to do this kind of work with you. It's very hard to get a child under six to open their mouths and allow us to take molds of their mouth if we need to make appliances. We have had some children under five, but it just depends on the maturity of the child or how you can work around the child. But it's really, really important that you get in there as early as possible. That is just so important. But we can see issues in children, as I said, from baby stage. And it's important that parents are aware of that and that they bring their children in regularly from age one or age two or age three, and that they bring them in on a yearly basis so we can follow them along and they'll get used to coming in, and maybe we can get in there to address issues earlier, particularly if they're used to coming in and seeing us and getting to know us, and you know, they won't have a negative experience when they come in, you know.